Max is in the building. Yep, the Royal Global Max is now shipping, and I've got one of the first ones. I think the serial number of this one is 11. So many of you have asked me for a review of this instrument because it promises to be a game changer for the sub $4,000 end of the market. And today I'm going to introduce it to you, show you its features, how it compares to the rest of the Royal Bass Clarinet line, and, of course, play it for you. So, without further delay, I present to you the Royal Max Low C Bass Clarinet. Now, for those uninitiated, you may be wondering who this Royal Global company is. Well, it's about 10 or 12 years old, based in Boston, and focuses on building high-end clarinets and bass clarinets that compete with the middle and higher ends of the market. These are instruments that are manufactured offshore in China, and I think they're opening a factory in South America as well, but I'm not sure that's operational yet. Anyway, they produce some of the best and only bass clarinets that serve the middle of the market. We're all familiar with the entry end of the market, instruments, you know, around $3,000, and there are dozens and dozens of manufacturers from Jupiter to Ridenour to Amati to RS Berkeley to Kessler and more in this category. And of course, we're familiar with the high end of the market with instruments from Buffet and Selmer retailing for, you know, $16,000. But until a few years ago, there was no one serving this middle price range. Then came Royal Global. Their Polaris and Firebird bass clarinets are tremendous values at $6,800 and $8,800 respectively. Great instruments in a new category that is now starting to grow with other manufacturers like Ubel, which I'll be reviewing in the next few weeks. But these two instruments that Royal makes, the Polaris and the Firebird, they put them in their professional line. Anyway, this summer I got to try serial number one. Number one of the Royal Max Bass Clarinet, and I immediately ordered 8 of them for the shop. They started shipping a couple weeks ago, and this is the first one off the bench from my fantastic technician friend, Miles DeCastro. Now, this Max retails for just under $4,000, and it is basically a Polaris that is made of a composite material. Royal created a category in their bass clarinet line called semi-professional, and this is the sole instrument in that category. So, I guess don't you dare call it a student instrument, or someone from Royal will put a flaming bag of poop on your doorstep. Interestingly, the Royal Max isn't plastic like the rest in the category. The body of the instrument is formed from grenadilla dust, which is reclaimed from the manufacture of Royal's wood instruments, mixed with a proprietary resin to form something like Buffet's green line material. So because it's mostly wood, the idea is that it retains some of the resonance of wood while being less susceptible to weather and humidity and therefore cracking. But you can't toss it around. It's still super fragile. It's more fragile than wood bass clarinets, actually, which have a longitudinal stability because of their wood grain. So let this be your warning. Please don't knock it over or drop it. So to begin this review, let's start with the case. It is the same case that comes with the Polaris and the Firebird, which is to say that it's not a bad case and it's not an awesome case, but it is much better than any student bass clarinet case I've seen, so that's a plus. It comes with a handle on the side and on the top. It has two hideaway backpack straps on the rear. It is a semi-soft case with a flexible water-repellent shell that covers some dense foam. I can press it so it doesn't have a piece of wood in it. But I prefer cases that have a bit more of a hard shell, just in case, you know, your car runs over it. But how often does that happen? So this is a decent case, and it's certainly the best in its category. Opening it up, you'll see that it keeps the instrument fairly well immobilized. It doesn't jiggle very much, which is great. Note that it comes with a sitting peg, but unlike the Polaris and Firebird, it does not come with a standing peg. Also, like the Firebird and Polaris, it doesn't ship with a mouthpiece or ligature. Putting the instrument together, I see that the neck and the keys and the bell are exactly the same as the Polaris, which is to say that it's silver-plated. And this, to my knowledge, is the only silver-plated instrument in this category. Coming up closer, let's take a look at the keys. Now, since it's a low C bass clarinet, it has right-hand thumb keys, and these come with the nice metal rollers, just like its bigger siblings. Turning the instrument over, you'll see the right-hand pinky keys, which are laid out just like the Polaris, and for that matter, just like the Buffet. Like the Polaris, the Max does not have an articulated G-sharp key, which means that playing F to G-sharp is, or B-flat to C-sharp in the lower register, is kind of cumbersome. The Firebird has an articulated G-sharp key, which means that this key here, which is the C-sharp, G-sharp key, when you push down the B-flat key, it pushes this down at the same time. It makes trills and tremolos like that just a breeze. I'm not sure why Royal didn't put this on all other instruments, because it's just a piece of metal that extends from the B-flat key over to the G-sharp key pad, but whatever. Another thing I appreciate is that the Max has adjustment screws for all of the low pads, which means that regulating these keys is much easier for your repair technician. No longer do they have to bend metal, which saves a lot of wear and tear on your instrument, not to mention a lot of money that you won't have to pay because it's faster to regulate. All this said, I found that all of the Max instruments I've gotten from the factory come with various issues. On one instrument, the neck had a leak in a solder joint, so my tech found the issue and he fixed it. On another, there was a tone hole that was cut badly and it looked like there was a chip out of it. As a result, the instrument wouldn't seal, so again, my technician buddy Miles resurfaced the tone hole and now it works perfectly. This is just to say, be careful where you buy yours and make sure that you can arrange to get it worked on either pre-purchase or post-purchase for a period of time. All right, enough talk. Let's listen to how this thing sounds. So the chromatic scale is super even. Each note is full and open, though this instrument does suffer from some of the same stuffy clarion E and F issues the Polaris suffers from, which they both inherited, for that matter, from the Buffet Prestige, on which all of these Polaris horns are based. And as you can see, it's basically in tune. Yes, it has the same issues all bass clarinets have, and namely that the throat tones and low F and E can be flat, and the clarion register can be a little bit sharp, but this is something that you can deal with and you will deal with on any bass clarinet that you own. It fills up the room nicely, even though I'm in the basement, and I love the low C. Part of the resonance of that note, by the way, is the vent hole in the bell. Which Royal Cop from Buffet, of course, that gives the low C this huge sound. Ugh, it's just enormous. Okay, so now let me do my usual blind playing test. For this, I'm going to play the Max, the Polaris, and I'm actually going to bring out the Kessler as well, because since this instrument is actually competitively priced to the Kessler, and people interested in the Kessler will probably be interested in this one as well. For this, I'm going to play the beginning of the prelude to the Bach First Cello Suite for something rich and legato, and the beginning of the same suite's Courant for something more articulated. So I'm going to turn off the lights in 3, 2, 1. Thank you. Could you tell which was which? Well, the first instrument you heard was the Polaris, the second was the Kessler, and the third was this Max. If you listen closely, you could probably hear the low C from the Max and the Polaris jumping out at you. And again, that's because of the vent in the bell, which the Kessler doesn't have. To me, the Polaris still sounds richer and has more of the high mid overtones around 5,000 Hz. Practically speaking, this means that it has more presence and will project into a hall better. It's also a bit more free-blowing than the composite Max material, because it's wood. The Kessler is still a good student instrument. It's got a different sound, it's slightly more covered, but the Kessler's keywork is totally eclipsed by the Max. So who is this Max for? Well, at $4,000, it's for a lot of people. For those with a low E-flat or student bass, this is an obvious upgrade for you. Doublers should also take a long look at this, as should folks in harsher, drier winter climates because of the fact that it won't crack because of climate or temperature issues. And for those who have a wood-based clarinet from the 60s or 70s or even 80s, the Max is an upgrade for you too. It's in tune, it's ergonomically superior, and it's just easier to play. Yeah, so the Royal Global Max is a total game changer. It's the one to beat in this category. It's about $1,000 more expensive than the rest of this segment of the market, but if you factor in the quality of the case, the fact that it's wood, I put in air quotes, and then it sounds like an instrument three times its price, I think you're worth it to spend the extra $1,000. Okay, that's it for now. If you've got something to say, put it in the comments below. If you have a question about anything else, visit me at earspasm.com and drop me a note from there. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, have a good one. See ya.